Hello again, everybody. It's Kat here. We're going to head into a classic upper body workout, really focusing on form, on the function of our motion, making sure that we're really making keeping everything in proper alignment. We're using weights that are appropriate for us. So I actually had to take the day off yesterday. Usually I take off Fridays, but you know, you have to mix around your schedule depending on what's going on with your body. My back is still bothering me a little bit, so I'm going to keep it gentle. I'm going to keep it easy and do a lot of supported motions. So we're going to start with a nice little warm-up to get our upper body warmed up. So we're going to start with a little boxer shuffle, whatever that means to you. We're just getting the body warm. If you want to go up and down with the arms, that'll definitely expedite the process. Is anyone at home also dealing with any sort of chronic pain or anything? If you are, I'm sorry, and just keep trying to find new and interesting ways to keep your body moving with the pain, through the pain, and in ways that don't make the pain worse for you. If something doesn't feel comfortable, definitely stop and find a more supported or a more comfortable way to do it. Okay, now we're going to go into nice shoulder rolls backwards. Especially if you have a desk job, it feels really good to open up through those shoulders, open up through that upper back. Switch directions. Make sure you're doing nice big shoulder rolls. Really getting into that deep tissue. Yes. Now we're going to head into some nice big arm circles now that our shoulders are a little bit warmed up. Okay. Great job, everybody. Do you want to do me a favor, honey? Do you want to give me my charger? Switch directions. Want to make sure that I don't die on you halfway through the video. Great job, everyone. Keep it moving. Okay, now separate your legs and we're going to go into windmill arms. So down and up. Down and up. Down and up.
We're just warming this home to show the new Curie cake happy brewer makes any house.
We're just warming up, so take it slow. Take it gently. We don't want to be pulling or straining any muscles when we're just getting started. Okay. Great job, everyone. Give me 3, 2, 1. Now you're going to put your hands behind you. Separate your legs a little, and at first just lift those arms away from your back. We're stretching through the sides of your back and your chest. How are you doing in here, baby girl? How are you? Yeah. Now, if you can, flip over to get into a nice deep chest stretch. If you want, shift back and forth between the legs. Now we're going to come up and down. Up and down. Up and down. 3, 2, 1. Now, I'm going to be careful with my lower back. Like I said, I'm going to take a nice big step out. Keep nice compression through my abs so that I have some support for my back. And then I'm going to head into a twist. If you can, come down to the floor. If you can't, you can just keep that hand on your leg. Give it a nice little bounce if that feels comfortable for you. And switch legs. And head into a nice bounce on the other side. Okay. And walk those hands back in. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. Get a drink of water, do whatever you have to do. And we're about to head into step 1. twice or three times. I haven't decided yet. It depends on how much burn I feel after the first time. Okay, come with me. We're going into a traditional bicep curl in 3, 2, 1. Here's from the side. Let those arms go down and up. Really make sure that you're feeling it through the entire range of motion. It's a good idea to use those elbows as a lever and to keep them glued to your side so that you're really focusing on that bicep. Hi, baby bean. Give me 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Make your way down to the floor, whatever that means to you. And we're heading into skull crushers. In 3, 2, 1, and go. As you see, I'm not using my heaviest dumbbells for all these moves. Sometimes for the first set, I like to just focus on my form, make sure that I'm really feeling it, and I'm really activating the appropriate muscles before I head into those heavier weights. We have 15 more seconds. Great job, everyone. Make sure that your weights are going to right around the top of your head, the most slowly and gently, so that you don't hit yourself. And rest. Now, shake out your hands, do whatever you have to do. We're going to head into a chest lift. In 3, 2, 1, and go. For a chest fly, we're keeping a bend in our arms. Our palms are facing each other. And we're coming out to the side. And in. Out. And in. Make sure you're really squeezing the weights together on the way out. That squeeze through the chest is really what's going to make the difference. 10 more seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. Put those weights down. Make sure we're not on the floor for this one. We are not. Find your way back up. Shake out. Do whatever you have to do. We're heading into a bent over row. Your hands can be either, actually, we're going to keep our palms facing each other because later on in the workout we're doing more of a wide row. So keep the palms facing each other. We're going to bend over slightly at the waist, keep that core engaged, and row. Sometimes if you have somebody around, it's a good idea to ask them to just watch one round of your form. If you're feeling uncomfortable or if you're feeling like something isn't right. For instance, I'm going to ask my fiance to watch if he doesn't mind my form and make sure that I'm doing this appropriately. He says I'm good, so I'm going to keep going. Especially for moves like this, where you could be putting pressure on your back, you want to make sure that you're really doing the right thing. Because for anyone that hasn't had the grace of getting lower back pain yet, you want to avoid it. And rest. Now you're going to head down to your mat for Supermans. We're also strengthening our lower back today. Your lower back is just as important to strengthen as the rest of your body. You're going to put your arms out straight, your legs out straight, just like a traditional Superman pose that you can put on your head. And you're going to lift and lower. Come with me. You can take it as slow as you need to. You also don't have to lift tremendously high. The
goal is just to strengthen those lower back muscles. 3, 2, 1. Push up. Shake out. Do whatever you have to do. Stand. I'm going to come over and get a drink. Now I can see you guys again. Hello. I'm going to play a video in the background so that I'm able to see you the whole time. I'm still filming using my laptop because if you're just starting a workout channel, my biggest recommendation, or any type of YouTube channel really, is to start with just the equipment that you already have. There's no reason to buy a million different things. You can really just use what you have at home. And if you realize that this is something that you really want to do, then buy all the fancy equipment. Don't just jump right into it. You might not like it. And go. Traditional bicep curls. I realized that I could bump my weight up a little bit for the bicep curls, so that's what I'm going to do. Now I'm at 15s. But starting with those 10s allowed me to realize that I was able to pump up safely with a little bit of a heavier weight. It also got those muscles activated before I just jumped in with my heaviest weight. So if you're going to be doing multiple sets of an exercise, that's a good rule of thumb, especially if you haven't done the exercises either recently or before. 3, 2, 1, and rest. We're making our way back onto the floor for those skull crushers, so come down however works for you. I love this song. Sometimes it reminds me what it was like to be young and wild. Yes. And that's fun. So you can either take one or both dumbbells. I'm going to try with both. Keep coming.
three, two, one. Now what I'm going to do for this second set of bent over rows is that I'm going to go single arms. You can try it if you want. You can go both if you want. Come with me now.
I'll put your mom in the kitchen. Make your blueberry muffins.
I just find it helpful in engaging my back sometimes when I'm just using the one.
Baby, why you flow so mean? Mr. Clean. Pull up on my whole damn team. Mr. Clean. Mr.
And switch arms. It also allows you to use a heavier weight on each side.
And you'll be like a pinhead. All my haze, baby skinheads. Pissed off because they wipe as a sister.
This is where you're wanting to pull the weight. So pull it right up to there.
Pull up on the sink. Cause a wet dream. I'm gonna need a summer rain.
And you should be feeling this in your back, maybe a little bit in your shoulder because we just did those Arnold presses. Three, two, one, and go. I'm going to alternate arms with this weight. My next round, I'm going to use a lighter weight. If you want to make it a little harder, turn up at the end. Turn the weight up towards the ceiling. Great job, everyone. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Now we're going to come back down and head into a chest press.
Hi, Jeannie.
Hi.
On the little feet.
In 3, 2, 1, chest press. I'm going into a wide chest press here. Keeping those abs engaged, keeping the lower back pressing into the floor. I've been realizing recently that for a very long time, I've been pushing my body without really thinking about my movements and where they're coming from and what parts of my body I'm engaging. So now, I'm really focusing on my form and making sure that every time that I do a rep of something, it's with the right form. The last thing anyone wants is an injury that prevents them from working out at all. Because one, it's not about a single workout. It's okay to miss a workout here and there. What does start to be a problem
is if you get really inconsistent. And obviously, if you have an injury, it's hard to be consistent.
So, I'm being gentle, I'm being careful, and I hope that you all use the opportunity to check and see. Maybe there's some moves that you're doing where you're not really paying good attention to your form. Now we're heading into a lateral raise. Yeah, lateral raise, exactly. To make it easier, bend at your elbows. The shorter the lever length, the easier it's going to be for you. Keep going. You don't need to bring it above your shoulders. As soon as you get in a straight line with your shoulders, you can stop and come back down. And make sure you're going slow, at the same speed on the way down as you went on the way up. Don't just drop those arms. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Great job, everyone. I'm going to pick up my weights. Now we're heading into a standing row for that back. So you're going to stand up and you're just going to row. Come with me in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and wide row. For anybody, whether you're a female, male, anybody at home that only focuses on cardio or only focuses on your lower body, it really is important to strengthen that upper body. Make sure that you have the strength to do your activities throughout the day, but also upper body strength improves your posture. So when you're sitting, when you're walking, when you're standing, having that upper body strength will make sure that you're not putting excess pressure on your joints. And rest. The last move is for our lower back, so we're going to come back onto the mat. This time our arms are going to be back, and we're just lifting our legs. With the hands down, you may be able to get a little bit higher. If you can't, that's totally fine. Just keep moving and doing what you can. Who's the cutest? Who's the sweetest? Give me 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Okay. want to. This time I'm going to do a couple hip circles. Just to make sure that I'm not building up tension in those hip flexors and my back and my hips in general. Back into those hammer curls. I'm going to try it with a little bit of a heavier weight. Okay, in 3, 2, 1, and go. I'm going to alternate. And always try to remind yourself, it's not about the quantity of reps that you're completing in the 30, 40, however many seconds that your set is that day. It is about the quality of those reps. You could do 100 horrible reps, and it's not going to make very much of a difference. Or you can do 5 great reps, and that can make a big difference. And you should, even though we're not killing ourselves today, you should be fatiguing by the end. Okay, I'm going to get my lighter kickback weight so I can just do kickbacks on repeat. Come with me. 3, 2, 1, and go. Keep that core engaged. Keep the arms kicking back. It's a good idea to turn them up at the end. You'll feel a little bit more engagement that way. Like might be time to purchase some new weights or purchase a set of bands if you don't have them. It's important to vary your equipment and to keep mixing it up. That's the best way to prevent getting bored with your workouts, supplying yourself with plenty of equipment. And one more, and rest.
The Woodford Reserve, quality is what we're judged against.
We're heading back into those back extensions. Come with me in 3, 2, 1. I'm going to put my hands on my lower back to try to feel if I'm engaging where I want to be engaging. You might be feeling this one a little bit in your legs. I'm definitely still feeling that leg workout from a few days ago now. I'll make sure to give you more legs and a cardio this weekend. So we'll have one legs and one cardio to make sure that we're keeping it mixed up and rest. We're keeping it moving. And like I said, all that matters is consistency. It doesn't matter which days of the week you work out. The order doesn't really particularly matter. It's keeping it consistent. Where I'm going to stay at the weight that I'm at right now, because I know that any I'll start to feel it in my shoulders. And not in a good way. And rest. Okay. This is the one move that I'm going to use a band during this workout. So you have to, if you have a band laying around, great. If you don't, you can just use dumbbells. Hold them together. And open. And open. We're doing this for our mid-back. I'm actually going to use one of my longer bands so that I can just pull apart rather than having the extra pressure on the wrist. So I'm using a long band, not a mini band. I'm holding both sides. We're just going to open across our chest and release. This is great for strengthening that thoracic spine or thoracic, the two. And that's an important part of our body to strengthen because we want to make sure that we don't have a very large arch in our mid-back. That leads to compensations in other places. If you're compensating in any part of your body, it's going to eventually show somewhere else. 3, 2, give me one more and rest. Great job. Now for our low back move, we're going to get into a crab position. Get up, and you're just going to kick. If you want an advancement, you can cross. I'm not going to do that right now. Feel free to. And if you have to, just hold. If it feels more comfortable to just hold where you are. You're still getting great stabilization in that low back. You're still working that, those glutes, that core. Give me 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Lower back down. Okay. Get a drink of water. Do whatever you have to do. We're going to head into the last round of this set. These hip circles feel good for me. Getting a little stretch in my back. Leaning forward. And I knew today wasn't the right day for me to do cardio or legs, but that my upper body would be a great idea to strengthen. So sometimes you have to switch up your plan a little bit. Okay. Back into those bicep curls. This time we're going to go 1, 2, low, 1, 2, up, down. 1, 2, down. From the side.
Made it.
keep checking yourself with these upper body moves. It's easy to find yourself holding your breath. Harper recently started really crawling. She's been scooting and she's been finding her way around just fine for quite some time now. But this added crawling is making her a fast-moving baby. And for anyone that has a baby, you can see how a fast-moving baby would be a little bit scary. She gets her way into everything. Things that we didn't even realize she could reach. So, this weekend is going to be a lot of baby-proofing. We've already started baby-proofing all of the areas where she normally goes, but now we have to expand to the rest of the house. But that's an 8-month-old for you. Happy 8-month birthday, Arborees. Yes, you are a whole 8 months old today. Feels crazy to me to think that it's been 8 months since she was born. It feels like it was just literally just yesterday, and I know people hear that all the time. Oh, she's en route to my ward. I'm sorry, Harper, you cannot have that. I need it. I won't know what to do otherwise. I'll get all confused. And rest. I would really suggest doing that mid-back for work for anybody that spends a lot of their day at a computer. Push up into a crab. Back to Harper being able to hold, like I was talking about. It's just so crazy for me to think that 8 months ago she was this tiny little creature that needed help doing absolutely everything, and now she's just scooting around on our floor with not a care in the world, trying to eat everything. Hey, no. No, 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 no. We're not playing with paint. Who told you could paint and rest? Who told you could paint, Amy? You're a baby. You're a baby. Okay. Now we're heading into our last set of this workout. We're starting out with a bisometric curl, an isometric bicep curl. In 3, 2, 1, you're just gonna curl and you're just gonna hold it here. And at first you might be like, oh, this is easy, what are we doing? Give it 5, 10, 15 seconds. You'll feel it. Like I was saying, stability is just as important as mobility. I said this in not this video, but our last video. If you have an amazing range of motion and you're strong, that's fantastic. But if you don't have stable joints, if you don't have that ability to hold isometrically, if you don't have the ability to hold your body up in a straight line without compensations, you still have a very high risk of injury. The strength and the mobility alone won't help. You need that stability work. You need that balance work. So make sure that you're finding a way to incorporate it each and every week. It's not something and rest that just goes by the wayside. You really have to make sure that you're finding new and interesting ways to challenge your body's stability. So, for this one, we're doing tricep push-ups on the side. It looks easy. Give it a try. It is not. Find a good position where you're really feeling it, and then lift up this arm. As soon as you can, as soon as you have the strength. If not, leave it down. This is a great way to target those triceps. It's a great way to work on the stability of our spine as we're moving up and down, keeping that whole spine in a straight line. And switch sides. Switch, switch, switch. It's good to start with your arm out just to figure out where your body should be. And then as soon as you can, if you can, use that arm. Just grip across your stomach, hold onto your pants, wherever you can reach. Or keep the arm straight out. I'm not doing that. That does not feel comfortable for me. But who knows, it may feel comfortable for you. Three, two, one, and rest. Ah, there's nothing better than baby giggles. Now, we're heading into elbow squeezes in front of you for our chest. This is our last set. We only have one more round of these exercises after this, and then we're done, so really push. We're getting towards the end now. We're warm, we're ready, we're moving, we've made it this far. This is great for any women. If you're wanting to be a little perkier for the summer, this is a great one to do. Maybe drop to your knees for the push-up. Whatever you have to do. This is the last one. And rest. Whew. Great job, everybody. We have two more moves of this round. You need to repeat it one more time. And then we're done. Pick up a set of weights for a wide row. So you're gonna bend over slightly at the waist.
Hi, baby.
Hi, baby.
Music
is a really important part of the show.
And you're gonna
row
out wide.
It is a lot of fun riding for a character.
Keeping those palms facing behind you. If it works better for you, go one arm at a time. That's what I'm gonna do.
I got the work with Timbaland. That alone still makes no sense to me. Like, I just did four songs with Timbaland? Like, what? Step of hard water. All of this, so it's no screening.
In 5 seconds, switch if you're doing single arm. If not, keep doing what you're doing. Friday. It's been a long week. There's been a lot going on at work and at home and with me and just in general. So, super thankful that it's Friday. Find new ways to motivate yourself. That's what's motivating me to finish this workout. It's Friday. And if I do it now, I don't get to do it when I get home later. This is the last round of triceps. Give me two more on this arm and then we're gonna switch. One. Swing those legs. Go as fast or as slow as your body can handle. This is a nice way to work your triceps, but it's a bit different than other tricep moves. You can do it anywhere too. You don't need weights. So this is a great option. And the dips. If you're out somewhere, if you're at a hotel, you don't have any weights, this is another very effective body weight workout and rest. Whew. Okay, now we have those elbow squeezes. Last round of that chest. Okay, weights up and squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. As you're getting tired, make sure that you're not compensating in your form. If you start to feel too big of an arch in your lower back, head into this split stance. From the side, squeeze and open, squeeze and open. And rest. It's always good hearing that it's time that you're done. We have three more exercises. We're gonna go, no rest. Come with me into an inchworm. You don't need to come all the way up in between. That was nice enough to not include normal push-ups, so make sure that you're really utilizing this opportunity to get in some good push-ups. Rest. Okay. Two more moves. Wide row. I'm doing it one arm at a time. You can do both if that's comfortable for you. I don't know if anyone else finds it helpful, but I find this type of music so helpful for you too. In three, two, one. Switch if you're switching arms. Keep going if you're not. Alternating arms is also a great way to figure out if you have any sort of muscle imbalances between your two sides. So give it a try once in a while. Give me two. One. We're heading into our last move. Those bird dogs. This is to stabilize our lower back, to work our abs. Baby infant. Keep that core engaged. And rest. We have a surprise round of, you guessed it, push-ups. Go. It's only 30 seconds. Come down on your knees if you have to or want to. Get those elbows out behind you and just keep going. This is the last thing that we're doing. Then we're just going to stretch. So just keep moving. We're trying to burn out those arms. And as everyone knows, push-ups is a great way to do it. You didn't think I could really let you finish an arm workout without any push-ups, did you? Rest. We're done. Shake it out. Do whatever you have to do. Now we're just going to stretch. I'm going to stretch right here on the ground, so do what you want to do. You can stand up if you want to. We're going to start with that neck. You can give little arm circles on the other side if that feels comfortable for you. If not, just stay just like this. Switch sides. I'm also at some point this weekend going to be posting a video for your whole spine, a yoga video, yoga for the spine, because it really is important to find a time during the week to stabilize that spine. That's where all of our movements come from. So if you have a problem with your spine, you're going to have a problem with your whole body very shortly. Now shoulders. Please also stick around for the cool downs. I know I used to turn off YouTube videos right before the cool downs. I was like, okay, I'm done. I did my workout now. But the cool down is built into the hour. I do that on purpose. I don't want to just send you out to the world without having stretch. That's horrible. That's so bad for your body. Now triceps. And like I say, please comment below if there is a move that you have a question on, if you want to see specific cues for a certain move, if you want a certain type of workout that I haven't posted yet. If you let me know, I will be sure to do the best that I can in helping you. I want to make sure that everyone that's on my channel has everything that they want. Now we're heading into a bicep stretch and a chest stretch.
Bang.
Okay. Now I'm going to come forward. I'm going to cross, gently cross my legs. And I'm going to head into a chest stretch. You're going to push those arms out behind you. And you're going to stretch out that chest. Now we're going to roll those wrists. One direction and then the other. I'm going to really make a concerted effort to post at least one yoga video for you guys a week so that you're not just stuck doing the same yoga routine. It is so important to find a time for yourself to stretch. Make the time for it. Take, work out 5 days, do yoga on the sixth. Work out 4 days, do yoga on the fifth. You just need to figure out a time to stretch because eventually you're going to start to feel the repercussions of not stretching. This is our last stretch. It's going to be a nice reclined spinal twist, so take one leg across the other, twist it over. Oh. I don't know about you guys, but this feels fantastic. Hold this for as long as you want, pause the video if you want to, but if you're going to come along with me, we're holding for 10 more seconds. Come back up and twist to the other side. This feels fantastic on my lower back. Like I said, I've been having a bit of sciatica, so if anyone has any recommendations about what to do for sciatica, and you want to comment below, that would also be extremely helpful for me. I like to learn just as much from you guys as you guys are hopefully learning from me. We all have stuff to teach each other. So I'm going to stay seated for the last breath. Take a deep breath in. Release it out. One more time. Deep breath in. Release it out. Thank you guys so much for joining me. This is Kat, Strong Not Skinny. Please feel free to subscribe to my channel. I also have an Instagram account that's going to be Strong Not Skinny Kat. So if you're liking my videos, you're liking the content that I post, please follow me, let me know. Give me a like if you feel like it. And I'm going to be posting more videos to come. So thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And I can't wait to see where this channel and where all of our fitness journeys go. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.